Hey, what's up everybody? It's Peek out here in Singapore, and I am coming at you live again because I have another amazing guest to interview for you guys because I want you to know who my tribe is. I want you to know who I follow, who I look up to, who I want to, you know, introduce the world to because they're doing amazing things and the work they're doing is actually admirable as well as inspiring to my girl Kayleigh. And you can follow her at swiftbody if you're interested. Hey, Cotton, how are you? Hey.
Hold on. What's happening?
I see.
Better?
How you doing? Yeah. Happy Memorial Day weekend. How are you doing? Yeah. Can you hear me okay?
Yeah, I hear you. You see me all right? I have to turn my phone.
I can
I'm
see
seeing
you.
You sideways.
You are? Hmm? I see myself. I see myself vertical. No.
I have to turn my... It's good.
Gotcha.
You see me good?
Yeah, I see you good. It looks good.
Okay, good.
How have you been? Hey, what's up, Ashley?
Good. Huh? Oh,
Ashley, yeah. So okay. You guys, for those of you who don't know, this is Kayleigh, and I am so excited to bring you to her because she does something that I didn't even know that there was, like, you know, a term for, but it's called emotion coding. That's what you love, right?
Yeah. No, I found it, and I had a session done on myself. That's how I was introduced, and I fell in love. It was like my missing link. I had done life coaching for about a year, and I was making so much progress, but I was still having like this block, and I was like, I don't understand why I've worked so hard. The cycle comes up and I'm almost there, and then boom, I'm like, what is happening? And then we found this, and it was just kind of like it helped me break through those patterns, you know.
Okay. Yeah, really. I mean, I knew a lot about energy, and you know, I'm starting to like learn a little bit more about energy healing, but the emotion coding part of it was different for me. So I've actually been through two sessions with you, and I mean, we don't know each other outside of just Crown for Success, and that has nothing to do with my past life or your past life, none of that. So for you to be able to, like, pinpoint a couple of those things that happened to me, I mean, and I knew exactly what it was. You were able to give me, like, an age timeline, basically, of when it might have happened and what it had to do with. And the way that it worked was very simple process. Obviously, yeah. I know what happened. You can tell me what the emotion was that's trapped or whatever, and I could feel it trapped, and the way that you go about releasing it was actually really simple, and it doesn't, I mean, obviously, it's not the same for everybody, but for me, it didn't release right away, but over the course of a couple of days afterwards, because you begin thinking about it a little bit differently, kind of like, it releases that hold of you, you feel a little bit different. So, just for those who are joining and don't actually understand, would you mind telling me how you got into it? I mean, I know you went through, like, a situation where you had it done for you, but what made you even look for that?
So, like I said, I was a single life coach, and I was just having this, you know, block, and it was a friend of hers. She's like, you know, I know this lady. She does, you know, explain to me a little bit about it. I was like, okay, you know, I'm totally into anything. I've always just been into really, like, natural type of healing.
Yeah.
I think our body's made to heal, and I love the holistic approach. So, I'm like, I'll try it. Talk to her. We had a really great connection, and it was the same thing, like, okay, she hit on some things, makes perfect sense, and then after about a week or so, I really was able to look back and notice the difference in my thought patterns. And I'm like, I'm like, okay. I'm like, it's so weird because, as you know, in the session, like, you really don't do anything. It's one of those, you're so used to having to work so hard for things, right? And it's
right.
And this session, you're like, I just sat there. Like, and I don't even, sometimes you might feel a little, like, tingly. I've felt that before, or, like, some sensation in my stomach, but sometimes I feel absolutely nothing. And I'm like,
right.
Okay. Like you said, after a few days, you're in a processing.
Right, but I totally feel you because you said you sat there and you didn't really do much of anything. You're waiting for something to happen. And I kind of felt the same thing, but then like a couple of days later, you know, it kind of happened. So I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, you're fine. So after I had the session, I was like so intrigued. So I bought the book called, I'll show you real quick. This book is called The Emotion Code. You see that there? is written, that particular book was written by Dr. Bradley Nelson. He's a chiropractor, and so he does certifications and goes around speaking, and so you probably find some YouTube, he does webinars all the time, so if you're really curious about it, definitely talks more about it. It is something that, you know, he says anybody can do and learn. It's something we possess as far as muscle testing someone, because you can do it in person, but you're actually muscle testing the person.
Right.
I do it more proxy where I use myself because I found, some thought just occurred to me while I was learning about it. I'm like, you know, I've always picked up other people's emotions like right. around me. I always, it just, it carry, I pick it up, like I carry yeah. it. So I'm like, I wonder if I'd be really good at just doing it, this, like using it for something positive. I'm like, if I have this, well, it's yeah. been torturing me. I'm like, let me use it for something positive. So I tried it on a few of my clients. I'm like, let me try something on you. People that are open-minded, and I'm like, okay. And again, I picked up emotions in their events mm-hmm. like right away. So I was like, okay. And they started learning more. I'm going through all their classes and everything for them, and I'm learning more and more, you know, as I go along. But it's just, it's so cool to me. And I love the fact that it's so non-invasive on every level. Like, I'm not telling you I'm a psychic. Like, I'm not reading into your past or your future. I'm simply asking your body. Your body's telling me this year, this emotion. And then you have the choice whether you want to discuss it with me more just as part of the process, or you yeah. can keep it like, yes, I know. And then I can ask, is it this? Yes, it is. Cool. Your subconscious always knows what emotion we're talking about. So whether your conscious mind remembers it or not, it's not important. You know, you don't have to remember it during the session. You don't have to remember it later, because your subconscious mind remembers everything. And that's what we're tapping into, your subconscious mind.
And I love the fact that you, I mean, for me personally, you were able to tap into something that happened to, you know, generations before, like my mother or my mother's mother, something yeah. that I kind of like handed down to me a little bit. So that was kind of amazing. And I think that, because the first thing I want to do is talk about it, right? So I told you about it, and then I went off and I talked to my mom about it. And I think it kind of helped her release some of that, whatever she was, you know, feeling upset about or guilty about, whatever the case may be. Like, she was able to, because I brought it up, she was like, uncomfortable at first, of course. And then she was a little, you know, she was able to kind of release it a little bit. I could feel like, you know, there was a little less tension between us. So that was kind of cool too. With all of this energy work, right, you are a very physical being. You play a lot of sports. You coach people. So I'm curious, has that translated very well across your coaching and your fitness practices?
I'm really loving it. Honestly, I feel like I'm finally finding what makes me happy, because I get bored doing the same thing. So yeah. for me, being able to train somebody physically, but then also on an energy level, I feel like I get much more variety, but I also get to hit my clients on such a deep level. Because yeah. when you're talking about somebody who's starting to live, trying to live a healthier lifestyle, well, we've already developed these patterns, but why? Why do you want to lose the weight? Why do you want to get stronger? Why do you want to do that particular class? Why did you get to this point in your life? How did you get here? There's such depth and emotion attached to that. We eat emotionally. Like, come on. You know,
you're not going to do something unless you really want to. And that's all emotion, right?
Exactly. So it's all mindset, emotion. It just creates such a more well-rounded. I like the analogy where we liken it to pulling the wheat from the root. Weed from the root. So I'm not just going in and getting from the surface, okay, we took away that bad food. Okay, you're good for a few months, but eventually you're like, oh, you know, I just want to enjoy. I can have one. I've done really good, right? And then you have the one, and then before you know it, you're kind of gotten this cycle of these ups and downs. And so we need to get that root problem out of why are you craving that? Why are you self-sabotaging? Why do you not love yourself enough to take care of yourself? Yeah. So all these deep-rooted things, you know, it can be generational patterns like you talked about. They can be an inherited thing where, you know, they say obesity, you know, it can be genetic, but really is it this emotion that's been trapped, inherited through your generations that has not blocked you? You know, and you're trying your best. You really are, and I understand that so much because that was me. I was trying so hard. I was doing everything. I was doing the work. I was looking at myself in the mirror and doing the work. Yeah. And I'm like, I don't understand why I can't break through. And, you know, I was able to release a lot of generational things, and it made a big difference. You know, it's not an end-all, be-all. There still takes work after it, but it's such a nice, you become way clearer in your thinking. There's almost a realization where you become more authentic. And once you own and you are authentic with your good and your bad, it almost like allows that bad to release and go on, because you've just been like, you owned it rather than fighting it. You stay in that fight when you fight it, and you just keep back and forth. Once you accept and you're like, okay, that was my emotion, that was whatever, it's like, cool, you acknowledged me, now we can move on. And it goes.
I felt like I could breathe a little bit easier. Yeah, for real. Like, I could breathe a little bit easier. It was some heavy stuff, though.
Physical symptoms.
Yeah. I got tingles. You mentioned you felt like something in your gut a little bit, like, you know, like a heavy feeling in your gut.
From time to time, I'll feel some of the people's when there's stronger emotions, you can definitely have more physical, but even still, like, you can do this emotion code around pain. So somebody maybe has chronic neck pain. Yeah. Well, say, like, right here is actually linked to, like, your kidneys. So we could find out, okay, you have your there's an imbalance within your kidneys. Let's see if there's a trapped emotion around that's lodged in that area causing the energy to be off. So then we go and trap it, and you can instantly almost relieve pain.
Yeah, I love that. So you've been doing this for a while. You've been so gracious enough to, like, offer us to us, excuse me, as queens in our, you know, Crown for Success tribe at a discounted rate, but I don't think people understand the impact. Like, even in regular medicine right now, I feel like doctors depend on the fact that you're going to come back. If I go to the doctor here in Singapore, they will give me one medicine for every symptom that I claim and then charge me for it. But you're not, like you said, you're not pulling it out by the roots. You're just kind of like, you know, killing it on the surface and hoping it doesn't ever come back. So I love the fact that you're digging really deep with these people as soon as they allow you to, you know, to sense for them whatever it is that their body is trying to, their subconscious is trying to tell them. Is there anything that you're getting ready to release? Like, are you going to do group coaching or lessons or any of those things? Because I feel like this is something that's, like, emerging generally. a lot of energy healing, seriously. So you're dealing with emotions, yeah, which is amazing. And I'm just curious, like, what are you doing next?
Right. I'm definitely wanting to work on a course. So that's in the process. I want to develop, like, a 12-week course where I take people who really want to change their lifestyle. Like, I'm not living healthy. I'm not feeling good on every level, physically, mentally, emotionally. And we're going to go through and just, you know, really create that baseline, create those goals, and really take a nice journey down learning how to, as a trainer, there's a lot of trainers who, not all, that they're never going to teach you. They're just going to coach you. They're just going to give you the workout. Here's the workout. This is what we're doing now. I want to teach you how to do your own.
And that's what I wanted to say. I'm so glad you said that. That's what I want. Like, I mean, there's plenty of people out there waiting for you to come back. So come back. You're going to always need me. I need you to need me so that I have business. Yeah. But what was it? They say, you know, teach a man to fish and he will eat for a lifetime. So I love that you're actually doing it that way instead. You want them to be able to take care of themselves. I think a lot of people are very self-aware, but being self-aware isn't enough sometimes. You kind of need to know what to do next,
right,
or how to take care of
it. Yeah, it's like, I feel this way, but what do I do now?
Yeah.
So, you know, I want to use definitely with the emotion coding to get down on a deeper level. And so there will be some one-on-one time in that group. Ooh, my headphones falling out. But also, really just, you know, a course where they can learn and go through different work, learn about themselves.
Yes.
Learn some real information. You know, the supplement industry is a $1 billion industry. And
And
it's all fed on insecurities and half-truths. You ever seen that, it's a meme, and it talks about if women really truly loved and accepted themselves, how many industries would go out of business?
Oh, yeah, definitely. You know, all the magazines would be out of business.
I have something beeping in my ear, and it's driving me crazy. Hang on. There we go. One of my stopwatches is going off.
Oh, wow. See, she's a trainer to the core always. So, the beauty industry definitely would be out of business. Magazines would not be able to sell anything because, I mean, what are you going to sell next? 5 steps to what exactly?
You know, and I'm so tired of seeing these, you know, 30-day challenges. And they're not bad in and of itself, but I want people to understand, why are you doing it? And what's next after this? Because, cool, if you want to do that 30 days because it looks fun, that's awesome. But understand why you're doing it, why you think it's going to help you. What's your, at the very end of the day, why, the toddler, I'm going to be that toddler in your ear, why. And so we get to the bottom of, why do you want to lose that weight? What's the real reason, you know? Do you not feel sexy? Do you not feel good enough? Because those are your real
emotions.
Get rid of your worthlessness or unworthy or self-abuse, you know, you're just putting all this food in, you're just hiding, masking. So really, I want people to just be empowered and learn how to do this themselves and get rid of those lies and things that don't need to be there anymore, that's blocking your energy, just blocking that flow the way it should be.
And I think that's the reason why you and I vibe so well, because you want to teach so that they can fend for themselves. And that's what I want. I want a network of coaches or artists or whatever the case may be. I don't care. Like, I've interviewed like all kinds of people on here. But I want people to know that there are those of us that are really doing work that wants you to be able to stand on your own 2 feet at the end of the day. I don't want you to have to depend on anybody else. It's upsetting to me that people, you know, like, let's go with food, right? Acai was a superfruit, and suddenly something else is going to be a superfruit, and suddenly something else, you know, whatever's in season will be a superfruit, and then everybody goes out and buys it, and then, like, the next thing, the next big thing is, you know,
it's so
Moringa juice is back again. Yeah, all kinds of stuff.
So that's part of what I really want to do, is just get that education out. Whenever these new things come out, I want to pick it up like Mythbusters style. And so there'll be an ongoing support, you know, a community that we'll have, that I'm putting on Facebook. We'll have a right now you can find it at Strong AF. So it stands for Strong Absolute Female, but, you know, there's the other acronym.
I was going to wait to see what you said about that, because I know that we interviewed Kristen, and she has KBZ AF, and that's in front. So, yeah, I was just, you know, but it's nice. I recognize it. It's still got that little bit of feistiness. The other thing that I've noticed that you do is you actually, once you do the emotion coding, you actually pair everything up with essential oils or crystals that give us a better idea of how to keep. It's easy to get into a place where you feel good. It's hard to stay there. And from what I understand, you have a really innate knowledge of all the essential oils and how to, like, how that smell will bring that feeling back a little bit and hold it a little bit longer. So I love that you're doing that. How did you get into the essential oil part of it?
It's funny enough. My daughter's teacher introduced me. Well, I've known about them for a while, but she got me into my first, like, you know, kit. And she's invited me to all these different things, and they were always free classes they were putting on. It was learning, so it was cool because I didn't really spend money. I'm like, okay, cool, I'll go learn. I'm always into learning something new. So that's part of what I do as well, is I educate on the oils and do classes on them. There's such an emotional component to oils, and it's kind of funny because you don't think that at first. There's definitely a good physical healing properties, but a lot of people don't realize the thing that scent is so tied to memories. And it can evoke certain emotions. Yes. So like rose, for example, I love that there's a book here, and if you read what rose means, it talks about really connecting with the divine and just a full love. So whenever you smell, I mean, think about it. When you go smell a rose, aren't you just filled with such good, happy,
it's like a joyous feeling. Yeah.
Yeah. So there's all these different, you know, oh my gosh, like oils, and they all come with like cilantro. Or here, we'll go with cinnamon. Cinnamon, the oil of sexual harmony. So it helps people who are body shaming, fearful, controlling, jealous, sexual abuse, sexual repression, or overactive sexually. And so it helps you accept your body, feel more attractive, feel more accepted, healthy, sexually, and intimate. So it's just, there's so many oils you even think, like, cinnamon, really? Like, so if you're having some trouble there.
I was going to say, know? Cinnamon. The cinnamon, I mean, I knew that cinnamon was a really good, extract or whatever to put in your food to kind of keep your hunger cravings and everything. So I guess it's all cravings.
Yeah. So it goes, it goes with, keeping your blood sugar under control. So there's these good physical aspects, but it evokes these other emotional things as well, which is really cool. And so what I do is I'll continue to muscle test you for a blend that might help you with whatever you're going through at the time and processing. And I'll come up with whatever it tells me. Sometimes 3 oils, 5 oils, 1 oil, whatever it tells me, whatever your body tells me. And just let you know what it is, how to take it, and it's up to you from there. I can't force you to take it.
Rub it on. Yeah. But it's all good. I mean, it's nothing that's invasive. It's very simple. You take it or leave it, you know, and if you if you come into it with an open heart, I mean, who knows? You could learn something that will really change your life and make everything easier for. I mean, isn't that what we're all here for? We're trying to find a better way, an easier way to do things. Because obviously, what we're trying isn't working, so we go outside for help, right? So, I'm excited. I like your work. I had never heard of emotion coding before, but I know a lot of my energy work itself. So, keep doing what you're doing. I'm so proud of you. She just graduated, y'all, so look forward to bigger bigger things coming from Kayleigh here. Please go follow her. Her Instagram account is swiftbody. That's it, right? There's no underscore. It's just Swift Body.
Nope.
Yeah, okay. I was trying to think of it in my head. Yeah, it's just Swift Body. And she has a lot of pictures on there with all the things that she does, like all of her sports that she plays. And I'm looking forward to more stuff on your motivation and your emotion coding, all that stuff. So I love you so much. Thank you so much for taking the time.
Thank you.
And thank you. I'll probably be back for another session soon.
Oh, yeah. Well, I look forward to it. It's a pleasure working with you and everybody else. I love hearing and learning about all you guys and helping any way I can.
We have a hell of a network, don't we?
Yeah, we do.
All right, Ma, thank you so much.
Look out for me.
Yes, please. I will link it in the stories as well so you all know exactly where to go follow. But it's SwiftBody. That's all it is. Okay?
I believe my website's in my bio, so you can find out everything from there. Oh, cool.
But check her out and do, please, if you're open to it, go check it out. Do an emotion coding session and see for yourself because, like I said, it's not invasive. And if anything else, it's intuitive. It gives you a little more insight and you probably don't realize you're holding on to some of these things. It's like, you know, just in the back of your mind running for some reason. So, I mean, it was worth it to me. I did it twice. So thank you so much once again. And I will talk to you soon.
Thank you.
Bye.
Take care.